You can stand to your feet. Stand to your feet. Whoa! Stop that! Okay. I know! And just let's enter into worship on a day today. He's so worthy all the time. But you know what? Today's an extra special day. So we just thank you, Lord. We just give you praise, Father God, in the name of Jesus.
Yeah. Yes, God, we thank you for this day. We celebrate you, Jesus, for rising from the grave. That was we thank you for what you've done for us, bankrupting heaven for us, so that you may come and die for us. Your blood covers all sin in this place, and we thank you, God, for this resurrection day. We want to invite everybody to come up to the front and worship the Lord with us in spirit and in truth. Go ahead, Tom. This is Jesus in his glory, King of heaven, dying for me. It is finished, he has done it. Death is beaten, heaven comforts me. Sacrifice. See him there, all in the name of love. Broken yet glorious, all for the sake of us.
This is Jesus in his glory. King of heaven, dying for.
Mercy so undeserved, freedom I should not know. All my sin, all of my hidden shame, died with him on the cross. Eternity won for us. Greater love, greater love, no one could ever show. Mercy so undeserved, of freedom I should not know. Everyone in this place, sing that out. Sing it straight to Jesus. Such love. Such love. Such love. Such love. This is for me. We thank you for the blood. Such love. Such love. Such love. This is for me. Yeah, just sing that out. Yeah. to the Lord. The veil is removed. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. And His blood is giving us freedom. He bought us back from sin. He bought us back. And He gave us freedom. Freedom to live, freedom to run, freedom to dance, freedom to live through Jesus. Yeah, just lift your voice to Jesus. The Lord is calling you deeper. The Lord is calling you higher.
Thank you for the blood.
Did I hear somebody blow a shofar? I just heard the Lord say, I want to hear that shofar sounding in this place. If there's a shofar lying around, there's multiple around here, just blow the shofar, blow the horn in this place. The horn of victory. The Lord has won. Jesus won. This is Jesus' victory.
We're more than conquerors.
All of heaven rejoices. Through the victory of Jesus.
We have the victory.
Yeah, just blow it one more time.
Hallelujah. Sing.
to tried, your king.
And it was defeated.
You are the risen king.
You are high and lifted up, God. And you're seated in majesty.
You are the risen king. Death could not hold you. Just keep praying, just keep worshiping, just keep lifting your voices. Let all of heaven hear it. Yeah, we're rejoicing with the angels, for Christ has won. For Christ has won the victory. We're rejoicing with the angels. We're singing with the angels. Bring it down. Unto the Lamb in the midst of the throne, the beautiful Lamb in the midst of the throne, the worthy Lamb, the glorious Lamb slain. Sing again. Unto the Lamb in the midst of the throne, the beautiful Lamb in the midst of the throne, the worthy Lamb, the glorious Lamb slain. Just sing it one more time with your hands outstretched. Unto the Lamb in the midst of the throne, the beautiful Lamb in the midst of the throne, the worthy Lamb, the glorious Lamb on the right hand. I saw in the right hand of him who sat on the throne a scroll. It was written on the inside and out, and sealed with seven seals. I saw a strong angel. I saw a strong angel proclaiming with a loud voice, who is worthy? Who is worthy to take the scroll and loose its seals? Unto the Lamb, let's sing it together as one body. Unto the to take the scroll and loose its seals. But wait! One of the elders said to me, do not weep. Behold, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, he has prevailed. Oh, sing a new song.
You are worthy. You are worthy.
For you are worthy to take the scroll.
You are worthy. You are worthy.
And I sing a new song.
You are worthy.
You redeemed us to God.
You are worthy.
For you are worthy. You redeemed us to God. By your blood. Sing that again together. Isn't he holy? Isn't he worthy? Isn't he beautiful? He's alive. 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 Come on, some of you gotta sing that out. He's alive. 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 He has overcome the world. He's alive. He's alive. Yeah. He's alive. Yeah. He's alive. your glory, Lord. Have your glory, Lord. We don't take it lightly, Lord. We don't take your sacrifice lightly, Lord. You bore those stripes for us, Lord. You had your hands and feet nailed for us, Lord. You died an excruciatingly painful death, and we don't take it lightly, Lord. You paid the ultimate price, Lord, for us. You paid the ultimate price for us. And we don't take it lightly, Lord. Just lift your voice if you don't take it lightly in this place. All he's done for us. We will not forget what you've done for us. We will not forget what you've endured for us. We will not forget
the way you shed your blood on Calvary.
Place of the skull, you died.
At Calvary,
we'll never forget. We'll never forget.
On Calvary, you shed your blood for me. The blood that covers and sets me free.
Take a moment and just thank Jesus for the sacrifice he paid for us to be redeemed. Just take a moment, just thank him in this place. We will never forget. We will never forget what you paid. Yeah.
You laid down your life so we could be set free. Thank you for your blood, God.
I just want us to take a moment. I just feel like condemnation is entering the minds of some people, and the Lord says, do not be condemned, for Jesus did this willingly. We need to just take a moment to just admire and respect and revere Jesus for what he gave. Yes, he rose. Yes, he's victorious. And yes, joy springs forth from that revelation, that knowledge, but just remember, he paid a very hefty price, and we don't take it lightly in this place. He gave up his life willingly. Like a sheep that went forth towards the slaughter, he gave it up willingly because of his love. And he says it, not so people, he says that to take... He says, don't be condemned. Don't be condemned by a sacrifice, but just take a moment to just revere. Take a moment to just respect, regard what he's done.
makes the deaf to hear. Right now, in your blood, takes away the curse. Right now, in your blood, heals every disease. Right now, in your blood, it sets the addict free. Your blood, it makes the deaf to hear.
We declare it
right now. In your blood, it takes away the curse. Right now, in your blood, it heals every disease. Right now, in your blood, it sets the addict free. Right now, and God, I still believe you're the same yesterday. Right now, your love propels me to forgive. Right now, in your blood, it transforms my mind. Right now, in your blood, it brings the dead to life. Right now, you're the same yesterday, and today, and forever. And I still believe your blood is sufficient for me. And I still believe that you're
for me.
It's more than enough for me.
It's more than enough for me.
It's more
Today and forever.
You still have the resurrection power.
We still believe.
And we believe in God.
Sufficient for me.
One more time and we.
We still believe
that you're the
same
yesterday
and today.
Forever,
and we still believe
your blood is sufficient
for
us.
Your blood is sufficient for us. Your blood is sufficient for us. Sing it out. Your blood is sufficient for us. Your blood is sufficient for us. There's only one word to describe, and only one word comes to mind. There's only one word to describe. Come on, we're singing holy in this place. Holy, holy, Lord God Almighty, we're singing holy, 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 Lord God Almighty. And only one word comes to mind. There's only one word to describe. Sing it to your King. And only one word comes to mind. There's only one word to describe. One word, and only one word comes to mind. There's only one. to describe, and only one word comes to mind. There's only one word to describe. Thank you for your resurrection, God.
Holy, holy, Lord.
Conquered sin, death, and the grave. We thank you, Jesus.
Holy, holy, Lord God.
Holy. stare at the face of Jesus and sing that out. Holy, holy Lord God Almighty.
Above the heavens.
We exalt you, Jesus. Let's sing this out together. We exalt thee.
We exalt thee. We
Spirit, we ask for more. We ask for more. More of your glory. More of your peace. Yes, Lord. We ask for more. I feel like the Spirit of the Lord is here to release prophetic words, and I know that's not definitely not normal for Easter, but I just feel like the Lord wants to just encourage some people, the Spirit of the Lord, through prophetic words. Did anybody have a word or vision during worship that you felt like the Lord, if you open this opportunity, I know that I heard you. Is anybody like something's burning on your heart, not something like you can make up, but
well, what you said is actually very profound, because it says in the Word, if any of us is not knowing what to prophesy, it says the testimony of Christ is the spirit of prophecy. Ooh. So today, and the story of what we are remembering today, and Christ dying and being resurrected for us, is prophecy. It is the ultimate
Come
gift.
On.
Mic drop.
This was from yesterday, and just this whole weekend having such a different meaning to me this year than ever, from learning who God is and having a relationship with Him. But yesterday, I was praying with someone, and in gold, I saw my name initials being stamped into this gold. And it says, you know, that He's got our names written in His heart. And I saw that, and then everything went purple. And I know that's royalty. And I'm like, me? I'm like, okay. You want me? Okay. And I'm so thankful. Thankful.
Awesome. Awesome, awesome. You have something, Dottie, too? Come on. Come on up. Amber, you can come up, too.
So I was down on the floor and I was worshiping, and I said, Lord, give me strength to get, you know, I said, Lord, take this away. He said, no. He said, I'm going to give you strength to rise above it, to rise above, just not partner with it, but come up. It can still be there, but you'll rise above it. And He said, I had you in mind when I went to the cross.
As I was driving along the expressway, and I saw this in the spirit during worship,
There were the black-eyed Susans growing alongside of the road and growing in the road and growing in the median between the two sides of the expressway. And the car I was driving in was running over some of the daisies, but the black-eyed Susans, very distinct difference, was running over the black-eyed Susans, and God was saying, that's my glory, my glory, my glory, because, you know, the black-eyed Susans have that gold color, but they have the dark brown middle. The dark brown middle stands for the authority that we have in Christ. And then as I continued driving, and I went on the median a little bit, and, you know, normally we would get in a wreck, but God's like, no, you're not going to get on a wreck because you're on the direct path that I want you to go on, and nothing's going to deter you from the path that I have ordained for your life. And I know this is not just for me. I know it's for us. So we need to not let anything get in the way of where God's propelling us forward.
Hallelujah. So yesterday, myself and a couple other people, we went up to an Assembly of God church up in York, thinking we were seeing Todd White, but it was another guy. I think his name's like Michael Rowan or something like that. And we thought like we were viewing like some sort of like passion play, but instead we were seeing like this very, very graphic like depiction of Christ being crucified, and there were like actors and there was blood, and it was not something for children. And you know, when we were first watching it, we were like, why are we looking at such a, like, it looked like a horror film. Like, that's how much he was really getting into it. Like, he had blood smeared on his face and everything. But one thing that he said that really convicted my heart was he said things like, do you know what he did for you? I don't think you remember. And whenever he would describe something that happened to Christ, what kind of beating he received, how many lashes he received, he said, do you remember? I don't think you remember. And it really convicted my heart, and it was really convicting my heart this morning. Like, you know, it's amazing that, you know, we have the ability to celebrate Christ rising from the dead, but it is so important that we remember what he gave. And I just saw, like, there were a couple people, they were crying on the floor. Some people were crying because they were just overjoyed by what God has done for them, and some people were crying because they felt convicted or condemned or otherwise. But I think that it's important to know and realize that God didn't give you a spirit of fear. He didn't want you to feel condemned. He wants you to know that he did this in the name of love, and love's name is Jesus. And I was given Luke 10:19. It was, he gave you authority to trample upon serpents and scorpions and all the power of the enemy, and they shall by no means harm you. But a lot of people don't like to quote the very next verse, which is, do not rejoice in that spirits are subject to you, but rejoice that your name is written in the book of life. And I think some of us just need to, like, just let all the cares of the world just wash off us and just remember what God gave and what God did this day, and the fact that we have salvation, we have heaven, we have eternity to look forward to, we have to look forward to being with Jesus. And I just think that it's just amazing. And I just thank God for what he did last night and what he did this morning and this afternoon. Thank you, Lord.
It's on Kimmy's Facebook if you want to watch it. So for me, especially with this being like such a season of just like deep intimacy and us just really reverencing this day and what it symbolizes and what happened, I know a lot of people, I understood exactly what Jeremy was saying when he was saying like people were feeling condemned. Because a lot of times you think about the fact that he died on the cross and you feel unworthy for that kind of sacrifice because of things that you're currently doing or the lifestyle that you're living or the choices that you're making. But I felt like the Lord wanted you to know that he wants you to focus on the way that he's kept you, even in those bad situations and even in those bad, you know, decisions. You know, and there is another side to it, and you have to focus on what he's doing for you and through you in those times and where he's taking you to and not where you currently are. I mean, it's good to feel the conviction because that ultimately causes you to be edified, and then you become transformed, and that's what this is all about. So I just wanted to just touch on that.
Amen. That goes kind of like what God gave me, just short and sweet. The Lord said that you are accepted in the beloved. And he said that you are not bastards. And he said that he died on the cross for us. And all you have to do is just cry out, Abba, Father, and I'll be there for you. That's what he gave me. It was very short, very sweet, but it lines up with what he's saying. He wants you to know that you are accepted and you are loved in him. If man fails you, God will never fail you.
Hey, Mike, come on.
There's two things during the service, during the worship, really. I kept hearing, God loves you. I really think there's somebody here that doesn't feel that they're worthy of God's love. I don't know who it is. But I think there's somebody that just like, God cannot possibly love me. And, you know, with Jesus being on the cross, you know, that proves that God loves you because he did it for everybody that came before, every sin that was happening then, and every sin that will ever happen. And all you have to do is believe in God. Now, yesterday morning, actually, Friday night, I was here a little bit, and Pastor couldn't shut up, so I had to listen to what he said. So Saturday morning, I got up and prayed.
I'll play that video with you and Jeremy.
Okay. What about the one with us? Saturday morning, I got up and prayed, and I kept going back to like four people. The Holy Spirit was just even telling me what to pray. And two of the people were Pastor David and Pastor Tracy. I got up and I started reading my Bible after I prayed. I prayed for like an hour, which is pretty unusual for me. I can't concentrate for that long. And I got up and read Philippians 2 about being imitating Christ's humility, that he put himself up as a, he was just humble, he was the servant of everyone. And I can't tell you guys how much your two pastors are like that. So I want Pastor Tracy to come up here. And one thing you might not realize is that these two guys actually need prayer for them because they pray for everybody, and I don't know how many people here pray for them. So you mind joining me in praying for them? It's like I pray for Pastor David and Tracy, for all that you've done, for all the people that you help. You're just such a good example on how to be like Jesus. I mean, I can't go on about that. You help so many people. You go through the list of who you're supposed to help, and you help them, and you help more people than that. You've taken every. People don't understand what a blessing is. A lot of people just think it's money, and it's not. It's a blessing is being able to do something for somebody else, and God's going to bless you with things that you don't even know what he's going to do. You know, he's going to bless you with a great marriage. He's going to bless you with all sorts of things that, and not necessarily money or material things, but then when you give like everything you have for everyone else, he's going to bless you even more than that. Because when you guys get up to heaven, you're going to hear a good and faithful servant. And, you can't be that close to, like, who Jesus is without God, like, saying, come here, sit next to me. This is your place. So I ask everybody in this church to pray for the pastors every day. Just keep them in your prayers. In Jesus' name, everybody said, amen.
Wow, thank you, Lord. You know, since Jeremy brought up the passion play, I was thinking about this one scene in The Passion of the Christ, and it's like my favorite one. It's that like Jesus is carrying the cross, and he can't endure the weight, and he falls to the ground. And his mom goes to pick him up, and he goes, look, Mom, I'm making all things new. And it just destroys me every time because the way up is down in the kingdom of God, and the way that seems right to man is oftentimes the way of the world. And so he calls us to walk by the narrow gate and walk the narrow way. And, you know, I just think that that all of us should stir ourselves into the things that God has for us, because there's just so much, there's so much glory being released in the kingdom of God, and all we have to do is say yes to the will of the Lord, and it's really, really precious. So there was this, the spirit of prophecy was really heavy during worship. I pray that God was speaking individually to you, because when the Lord starts speaking and when the Lord starts pouring out his spirit, it's a time for God to reveal himself to you in an intimate way. And I appreciate everybody sharing. And here's one thing you want to really do is when the Spirit of the Lord starts moving, and just start asking questions. It, just make it really simple. God, you're really moving unique right now. What's on your heart? What would you have me to do? And that's one of the things I always try to do. You could get really excited if you sense God moving and go to some default mechanisms. Teresa had said that she felt like there was a strong prophetic move and peace and healing. So if anyone in here needs peace or healing, just reach out. Say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for peace. And thank you for healing. You are the Lord that healeth. You are the Lord that heals. You are Father. You are the great physician. You are the Lord that heals. Right now, Father, we just receive healing in all parts of our body, and we thank you for divine health. If you have any area of your body just that's been bothering you, or blood situations, any of that, just give the Lord thanks, for he is good. He is your healer. And so if there's anyone that's struggling with just a lot of racing thoughts and not able to still yourself to have a place of peace, I believe that that peace is the same way. You just ask the Lord to give peace, and we just thank you, Lord, for that right now. Come on, peace over every home, over every person represented in this building, over everyone in Redemption House Life Center, and even spilling into the streets, the highways, the byways, God, the Holy Spirit, just go. And so we thank you, Lord, that peace rests in our homes, peace rests in our hearts. God, we come to take authority in the realm of peace over everything that we touch, everything we do. We don't have to live a life of frazzled Christianity, but a life of power, love, and a sound mind, full of peace, full of joy. And I thank you, Lord, for teaching us to reign with you, to reign with you in your peace, in your peace. We thank you, Lord, right now. Just put your hand on your head if that's something you need. God, we just thank you for peace reigning. Thank you, God. We thank you for all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Well, God bless you guys. Put your hands together for the Lord. Thank you for everybody sharing. I don't think we normally do that. I don't think I've ever done that. But thanks for everybody coming together and sharing, and just allowing the Lord to speak what's on his heart through you.